From Petco Park in downtown San Diego, we've got open-air baseball for you on the show. It's the New York Mets and the San Diego Padres. First pitch coming your way next. All right, ready to get underway. Here's Brandon Nimmo. The pitch. So a foul ball makes it 1-2. Kicks and fires. And a ball evens the count. That one ran inside, almost got him.
Straighten him up a little bit.
Left-hand hitter waits. Fouled off again, and it remains 3-2. And a pitch. There Nimmo checks his swing. Appeal down to third, and he held up just enough. That's ball four.
His ability to draw walks has been something that's been part of his career since day one.
Here's Starling Marte. Next offering misses. Counts full, 3-2. And here it comes. And ball four, two aboard.
Almost a coin flip for the umpire in that call, but most umpires just don't want to give pitchers a break up in the zone like that.
Francisco Lindor comes up to the plate. Here comes a pitch. Swing and a pop-up. He's got it, and that is a big first out. Here's Pete Alonso. He's not going to get cheated up there.
No, he's not. He's looking to do damage with every swing he takes.
He swings and fouls one off. One out, runners at first and second. And a foul ball, he stays alive. At the belt and fires. Swing and a miss, struck him out. And there's two away. So first and second with two outs. Mark Canna up now for the Mets. Kicks and deals to the right side. Cronenworth gloves it. They get the force. That's out number three. Bottom of the first, and stepping in is the speedy Trent Grisham. Well, who would have thought Jacob DeGrom as a college shortstop and then a ninth round pick by the Mets was going to turn into this good of a pitcher? Back-to-back Cy Youngs in both 2018 and 2019. The next offering misses. Now 2-2. Next offering is fouled back.
Flew open a little bit with that front shoulder, but was able to slow his bat down just enough to make contact with that pitch. Keep the at-bat alive.
Swing and a miss. The velocity blasted it right past him. Here's Machado, a guy who makes an impact not just at the plate, but also in the field. Swing and a pop-up in foul ground. Escobar under it. Puts the squeeze on it, and there's two down.
That was a good pitch to hit right down the heart of the plate. Had pretty good timing on it. Just got underneath it a little bit and popped it up.
Jake Cronenworth, the next up for the Padres. And a pitch. And that one almost got him.
Yeah, Boog, just incredible. You look at that benchmark of 200 innings, comfortably over that in 2018 with 217. And the sub-2 ERA just impressive at 1.70 to lead the league.
Next pitch has popped up. McNeil makes the catch, and that'll do it. Back back here at Petco Park. Second inning set to go. Eduardo Escobar, El Caballo up to hit. And a count 1-2.
He needs a quick 1-2-3 this time around. Last inning, threw a lot of pitches.
And the righty deals. That misses the zone. Ball two. Out towards left center. Profar settles under it. And makes the grab. One up, one down. Dom Smith stands in.
The designated hitter, Dominic.
The 2-1. And a foul ball. Two, two down. And he hits a ground ball right side. Cronenworth throws on to first. Two up, two down in the top of the second. Two outs, base is empty. And now here's Jeff McNeil. Two down, nobody on. And that one lifted in the air center field. Grisham settles underneath it, and he makes the catch. And that'll do it. Back here in San Diego, bottom of the inning, Luke Voit will step to the plate. Here's a 2-1. Stays alive. The pitch. Got him swinging. That's one out, the bottom of the second. Now it's Eric Hosmer.
The first baseman.
And Hosmer swings through it, struck him out. Already two out here in the home half of inning number two. Will Myers now. Next offering is fouled back. No score here in the second. Swing and a miss, struck him out. And good work there as he gets a 1-2-3. New inning getting started. Here's the catcher for the Mets, James McCann. Next offering is in for a strike. Righty delivers. And a foul ball, he stays alive. The pitch.
That's the ball. I got the count 2-2.
That one missed. And the pitch. Got him. Leadoff man retired here in the third. Brandon Nimmo up now for the Mets. He's someone that you might not describe as having elite level speed, but he can absolutely move, and it is a factor in his game. One down, base is empty. Swings through that one, it's a strikeout. Back-to-back strikeouts. Starling Marte up to hit. Top of the third, no score. And the next pitch is way outside. And the right-hander deals. Bounce to third. Machado throws to first in time. And the Mets go 1-2-3. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. Now here is Austin Nola. Next pitch is outside. Righty to the plate.
The count is full. 3-2.
It's a leadoff walk, and that's the go-ahead run.
Well, a breaking ball in that 3-2 count kind of tells you that that's the pitch he has the most confidence in right now. Just couldn't find the strike zone.
Now batting Jurickson Profar. And a 1-2. Got him looking. One gone, bottom of the third inning. And now the shortstop, Ha-Sung Kim. And he deals. And now 2-2. And a pitch. That one ripped. That's back. Makes the catch up against the wall. Now it's Trent Grisham to the plate. We talk about guys with good speed, and definitely he has it. But pushing the offense aside for just a second, Chris, it's the defensive side that I think the speed factors in the most. Next offering in the dirt, and it's 2-2.
Well, he gets to balls that get by most people at that position. Just really impressive because there are certain times the ball comes off the bat automatically. That
great effort as he's able to haul it in, and the inning is over. Welcome back as we go to the top of the fourth. Now up to hit Francisco Lindor. The pitch. Fly ball pretty well struck right field. That's back. Pulls it in on the warning track.
Plenty of extra carry on that ball to right there. Almost got out of here thanks to the wind. It's whipping right now.
And now it's the polar bear, Pete Alonso. He struck out swinging at his first at bat. And the pitch. And now 1-2.
Count is 1-2.
The pitch. And down on strikes he goes. Two quick outs here in the top of the fourth. Now batting. Here's Mark Canna.
Mark Canna.
Swing and a ball lifted left field. And puts the squeeze on that one. And that will end the inning. Ready to go, bottom four. Here's Manny Machado to start it off. Good plate appearance there. Able to take the walk.
Probably tried to nibble right there and just missed his spot. Hitter didn't offer at it. Now he has somebody to worry about over at first.
Here's a 1-1. Next offering is outside. Left-hand batter waits. And a foul ball.
So important for him to control the heart rate right now. He's got to go through the heart of this lineup.
The pitch. To third might be two. Escobar tossed to second. Not in time at first. It's a fielder's choice. Here's Luke Voit. Gotta be careful with this guy. He's got power. He can untie it with one swing. Next one is off the play, and it's 2-1. This one smoked out to left. Canna makes the grab, and there's two down.
He was all over that fastball right there. I tell you what, if he gets under it just by a fraction of an inch or a little bit more, that's way back.
That one is absolutely belted way back there. Bounces off the wall as he makes the grab. Back here at the ballpark, all set for the start of the inning. And now it's switch hitting third baseman Eduardo Escobar. Right side. Oh, he gloves it to first. On the money. Nice play. Now it's Dominic Smith. Grounded out his first time. The Mets hitless so far in the game. That one to first. And he takes it himself for the out. Jeff McNeil stands in.
Well, on the mound, very efficient. Able to produce an outcome, it seems like, within the third or fourth pitch of just about every at-bat.
The 2-1. Late that time, and it's strike two.
I think he was sitting off speed there.
2-2 now. That one missing inside. Hammered on a line to the left, base hit. Now he turns and heads for second. And that's a two-out double. It's their first hit of the game.
Man, those are the types of hits where you don't feel any vibration in your hands whatsoever. Such a good feeling. A well-deserved double on a great swing. Got everything going on time. He stayed balanced and he squared it up about as well as you could possibly ask.
Man on second, two down. Stays alive. McNeil at second with two down. And a swing and a miss. And that's that. And welcome back. We head to the bottom of the fifth. Stepping in for San Diego, Will Myers. Next one misses, three balls and a strike.
Here's an opportunity to do some damage and perhaps unlock this offense. 3-1 count, be ready to turn on a fastball.
Alonso collects, tosses to the pitcher covering the bag. Pitcher gets to the bag for the out. And now it's Austin Nola. Turned on, but that's foul down the third baseline. Right-hander kicks, deals. Next offering misses down and away.
Well, he might have to look for a different put-away pitch right here, 2-2. He's already seen the curveball a couple of times in this at-bat, so might have it timed up and ready for it.
3-2 now. And down on strikes. Two out. Two outs, base is empty. Now it's the switch hitting outfielder, Jurickson Profar. Struck out looking in his first at bat. The wide to kick the pitch. So a foul ball makes it 1-2. Two outs. Swings and misses. That's his second strikeout. Set for the top of the sixth. Digging in, it's the speedy outfielder Brandon Nimmo. Left-hand hitter waits.
It's good speed at the top of the order here. You want to get it on, see if you can get a stolen base, maybe get around the bases and pick up a run.
And now it's even up. And a foul ball, he stays alive.
Definitely got the hitter conscious of the pitch inside. Really think the outer half is open.
Kicks and deals. Swing and a ball popped up. Cronenworth makes the catch, and there's one down.
Well, that was a pitch you got to crush. Unbelievable that he missed it right there. And I'm telling you, he is going to be frustrating with himself until his next at bat.
And here it comes. Off the plate inside. And that's ball three. Here comes a pitch. 3-2 now.
It really looks like these hitters have been in between with their timing today. Good fastball, excellent slider, but they've not been able to commit to one velocity and stay there.
In the air out to center. Grisham on the move as he glides back. He's got it, and there's two away. Here's Francisco Lindor. You talk about elite defensive players, especially in the middle of the diamond, and this guy is at the top of the list. That misses the zone. Now two balls and a strike. And you played behind guys, and they loved having your speed out there defensively. One of the things that we talk about is how much pitchers enjoy having those elite defenders behind them. Profar makes the catch, and that'll do it. Bottom of the six, digging in, Ha-Sung Kim.
Boog, and the one thing about that is speed never goes in a slump, and defense shouldn't either. Hitting-wise, you can struggle, you can lose your mechanics, but the thing that you can do consistently every single game is play great defense if you're talented in that way, and this is what this guy does.
The 3-1. And a strike. Swing and a miss, struck him out, and he's down on strikes for the second time today. Two outs, base is empty. Manny Machado, the next up for the Padres. The 1-1. Swing and a foul back, that's out of play. And a pitch. And Manny gets a piece. The wind of the pitch stays alive. The wind of the pitch. And a foul ball, he stays alive. Pitch misses there, and the count is even, 2-2. Two down, nobody on. That one misses, and it's 3-2.
He should get a pretty good pitch to hit here with three-hole hitter coming up if he's walked.
Got him. The big righty strikes out the side. Back here in San Diego, top of inning number 7. Stepping in, Pete Alonso. Here's a 1-2. Swing and a miss, and he is down on strikes for the third straight at bat. Mark Canna up now for the Mets. Righty delivers, and 1-2.
.99 pitches, about to throw his 100th here in the 7th inning. This is where you really start looking for any signs of fatigue.
And another ball. And the righty deals. way high.
At this point in the game, you cannot issue free passes. He's going to have to challenge this hitter. Hitter's got to be ready to swing it.
The pitch. High fly ball out to center field. Grisham moving in on this one. And there's two away. Here's the third baseman, Eduardo Escobar.
He's a big, strong guy, can untie this game with one swing.
The 1-1. In the air, right side. Myers makes the catch, and that'll do it. Welcome back, bottom of the seventh. So digging in now for San Diego, Jake Cronenworth. And a pitch.
Now you get to this part of the order. Yeah, there's some pop there, but more likely there's some base hits. So very important to be patient. But the pitch.
Oh, now this is blasted way back there on its way. Gone. Jake Cronenworth will touch them all. Just like that, they move in front. It's 1-0. And here's Luke Voit.
Okay, from here, he's got to treat this as a clean inning. Forget about the fact that his team is now down by a run.
That one in for a strike, 2-2.
Boog, that hook's looking pretty sharp today. Just a solid pitching performance so far, and I really think it's because of that curveball.
Popped up, Alonso moving under it. Drops into the glove, and there's one away. Here's Hosmer.
Now batting, the first baseman, Aaron Hosmer.
Kicks and fires. In the air to left center. Nimmo turns to the right on the move. Got it. Really had to move for that catch. And there's two away.
Well, those can be pretty fun as an outfielder. Got to put it into his highest gear and go a long way to track that one down. Nothing better than that. You feel like a wide receiver playing football.
Fouled off again, and it remains 3-2. The wind of the pitch. This one popped up, puts the squeeze on that one, and that is that. We go to the eighth, and now the Mets DH, Dominic Smith. At the belt and fires. Chases that one out of the zone. First out in the top of the eighth. So digging in, Jeff McNeil.
Jeff McNeil.
Is a 1-1. Good eye right there. The count 2-1. And that chance handled. Over to first. And a couple of quick outs. Here is James McCann. Next offering is downstairs. Looking to get the tying run on base. 3-1, and he couldn't come up with it.
Well, it might be time to dig into that bullpen. He's looking a little fatigued to me.
Brandon Nimmo up now for the Mets. And he deals. And a count 1-2 with a single base runner. Because of all the power, they are dangerous to tie this thing up or take the lead. The 1-2. Swing and a drive. This one is crushed. No doubt about it. And here in the late stages, they have the lead. towering shot. And now they're out in front. It's 2-1. Austin Adams gets the call from the pen. He's being eased into the game here with the bases empty. So up next for New York, Starling Marte. The pitch. That one ripped left field. And it's gone! They do it again. Back-to-back homers. And they add a run. It's 3-1. So two down. Francisco Lindor up now for the Mets. Next pitch misses. And that's ball two. Next offering is foul back. 2-2 now. And there's a ball. And a pitch. Swing and a miss. Slider right there. Fires to first on the run. That's the third out. Back here at Petco Park. And now here is Austin Nola. The pitch. And that one handled. Sends it to first. And a quick out number one. Now the left fielder, Jurickson Profar.
Well, both sides equally as strong. So not a good time to try to turn him around with a relief pitcher and put him on the other side of the plate.
One, two now. And that skips in the dirt. The punch out there, two away. Next for the Padres, Ha-Sung Kim. This is a guy who's in the lineup first and foremost because of what he contributes defensively, Chris. And when you talk about preventing runs from... Ah, that's strike three and the third out. So we take a break. So Craig Stammen into the game. And his job is to collect quick outs and keep his team within striking distance. Back here at the ballpark, all set to start the ninth in this one. Here's a big power threat, Pete Alonso. And the pitch. Got him looking. And that's the first out. And stepping in for New York, Mark Canna. The next pitch misses, and a count 2-1. Just missed.
That's where you want it. It's a good miss.
In the air, center field. Grisham in position. Pulls it down and he makes the catch. And there are two down. Eduardo Escobar digs in now. So a foul ball makes it 1-2. Pitch way inside, gets out of the way. Stays alive. Two, two now, and now it's filled up. Left-hand batter waits. Fouled off to the right. And down on strikes he goes. And that's the third out. Back here in San Diego, all set for the bottom of the ninth. Up now, the Padre leadoff man, Trent Grisham. That hits the dirt. Two balls, two strikes.
Good slider down and in can be so hard to get on plane with. You're better off taking that pitch.
Next offering upstairs. Right-hander kicks, deals. In the air, left side. Canna drifts towards it. Calls it in, and there's one away. Manny Machado up to the plate. A strikeout and a walk. Kicks and deals. And a count one and two. Swing and a miss, and he struck him out. Padres with only one out remaining. Next to hit, Jake Cronenworth. He's already homered here in this one. Two-run game, a two away here in the bottom of the ninth. Next offering misses, 3-1 now.
Pressure mountain right here with the tying run in the on-deck circle. He's got to find the strike zone.
Oh, now this one's high and deep, way back there, on its way, gone. So they turn to Edwin Diaz out of the pen, and he'll do his best to hang on to this lead. Luke Voit at the plate. Is just one strike away. Got him! And that's the ball game.
Well, a four-pitch save. He was just starting to get comfortable out there after throwing a lot of pitches in the bullpen in this one. But a nice job of attacking the hitters, being very efficient. And this is what you want to do. You want to come in and you want to close things out as quickly as possible.
3-2 the final score for Chris Singleton and our entire outstanding crew here at MLB The Show. I'm John Ciambi. Thanks for joining us.
The final line score for our ball game tonight for the victorious New York Mets. 3 runs on 3 hits, no errors. They left 3 men on base. For the Padres, 2 runs on just 2 hits, no errors. They left 2 men on base. The winning pitcher is Jacob DeGrom. The loss goes to Yu Darvish. Time of the ball game, 2 hours and 50 minutes. Thank you for joining us here tonight. And we remind you to please drive home safely.